But that's the police for you. So it seems. But we're not an item, Elaine, much as Joe and Lloyd Davis are trying to push us that way. And now you. It's not as if we can be, is it, with everything in the air, and me not yet ruled out from having committed one of the crimes? True, but it all looks very promising for where I'm standing. And there might have been another reason for wanting to come. She touched the side of her nose. It's not just walls that have ears, is it? Those fried onions smell wonderful, she added more loudly. I like them better than burgers, truth to tell. She set off purposefully into the beer garden, where not just two but three barbecues were in operation, staffed by three teenagers more interested in their phones. Come on, you need feeding, and I certainly don't. She grabbed some of the muffin round her waist and squeezed. At least Fizz isn't fattening, is it? Not when Brian Dawes buys it, I mouthed, winking. Some of the younger kids were already high on sugar and making a thorough nuisance of themselves, dashing round, jumping, shoving. Worse, any moment now one of them might career into a barbecue with potentially disastrous results. En route to warn Diane, the landlady, I spoke to a couple of mothers I knew from school. We have to move them away from here, or at the very least somehow fence off the danger area. Any ideas? I did have several myself, but since they involved the water butts on which Diane prided herself, I kept quiet. Talking about drowning infants would not be good for school recruitment. Diane, detailing Ed to take over the bar, hurtled out with me.